There was a little mouse running around in the grass place where he lived. One day he came to the edge of a grass place where he lived, and he heard a roaring in his ears that he had never heard before. He wondered what this roaring was. He went back in to the grass place where he lived, and he went to one of his relatives, and he asked, "Do you hear a roaring in your ears?"
"Roaring, there's no roaring. Go away, leave me alone."
Little Mouse decided to go talk to his sister, and he asked his sister, "Do you hear a roaring in your ears?"
"There's no roaring. Go away. See what our mother needs."
Little Mouse went to his mother, and he asked her, "Mother, do you hear a roaring in your ears?"
"There's no roaring. Go away. Go get me some dew off the leaves. Go find me some seeds."
Little Mouse could still hear the roaring, and he wanted to know what it was. He went back to the edge of the grass place where he lived, and the roaring was there. Just then,
"Hello, Little Mouse."
And he looked up, and there was a raccoon.
"I'm Brother Raccoon. And I know you want to know about the roaring in your ears. Follow me and I'll take you to it."
Little Mouse agreed and he started to follow Brother Raccoon. As they walked along the trail, Little Mouse felt dirt under his feet he had never felt before. He smelled things he had never smelled before. He saw flowers and trees unlike anything he had seen before. As they walked along, they came up and went up a little knoll. When they got to the top of that knoll, Little Mouse looked in front of him, and there had to be the greatest being in the world, for it was so great. It could move rocks. It could move tree trunks. It was frightening, and the roaring was loud. Brother Raccoon started to walk down toward this being. Little Mouse just stood there.
"Little Mouse, it's okay. Come with me."
So Little Mouse followed Brother Raccoon down to this great being. In this great being, there was a calm place with some green lily pads on it. And Brother Raccoon looked at Little Mouse.
"Little Mouse,
there on that, out in the river there, the sacred river, is Brother Frog. He is the keeper of this sacred river. I must go now, for I have other things to do." Brother Raccoon went on his way down the river. Little Mouse stayed there, and as he did, he got used to the roaring in his ears, and he talked to Brother Frog. After a while, he got closer to this great being, this sacred river. And he leaned over, and as he did, he saw another mouse, and he jumped back. Brother Frog laughed. "Little Mouse, that is your reflection. Do not be afraid of it." Little Mouse and Brother Frog talked some more. Finally, Brother Frog asked Little Mouse, "Would you like some medicine?" Little Mouse said, "Yes, yes, yes, what do I do?" "Pull your feet up under you as far as you can and crouch down as low as you can, then jump just as high as you can." Little Mouse pulled his feet up under him as far as he could. He crouched down as low as he could. And he jumped just as high as he could. And just before he came down, way off in the distance, he saw the sacred mountains. As he came down and as he landed on the ground, he was right by the river. He fell back in to the edge of the river. When he came out, he was scared. He looked at Brother Frog and he said,
"You tricked me! You tricked me!"
"Little Mouse, what did you see?"
"You tricked me! You tricked me!"
"Little Mouse, what did you see?"
But you tricked me!
Little mouse, do not let your fear and your anger blind you. What did you see?
I saw the sacred mountains.
Good, little mouse. Go back to the grass place where you live and let your relatives know what you have seen. Little mouse thanked Brother Frog and started back the way he came to his grass place. As he got to the top of the knoll, Brother Frog hollered out at him, Little mouse, you have a new name. It is Jumping Mouse.
I want to take this break and explain some of the first part of Little Mouse. Mice see things that are close to them. They investigate with their whiskers, and rarely do they look up and see things far away. The mouse is a symbol of the South, a place of trust and innocence. Little Mouse heard a sound that was a mystery to him, and he wanted to solve that mystery. When he went back to the edge and met Brother Raccoon, who was willing to help him solve the mystery, Little Mouse went with him to the Sacred River. The Sacred River represents life. Now, there is a man who lives in the South, and that is symbolized by Brother Frog. If we look around us, we will find that all things mirror some aspect of ourselves. Little Mouse saw that mirror when he looked into the Sacred River. It frightened him, as it does most of us, when we see ourselves reflected back by something we are unfamiliar with. We can all seek that Sacred River, but often when we see our own reflection, we retreat back to that mouse place and again go no further. Little Mouse did not do that. Now Brother Raccoon was the one who took Little Mouse to the river. We all have our own raccoon to help guide us to that place. But we have to decide how we will proceed from there. Raccoon, Little Mouse's guide, only took him to the river. Little Mouse had to discover for himself what he was going to do from there, as his guide was just that, a guide. That is a little part of insight into the first part of this story. So now let's see what we may discover in the second part, Jumping Mouse.
Jumping Mouse went back to the grass place where he lives. When he got there, all of his relatives started to run up to him, and then they stopped and backed up. For Jumping Mouse was still wet, and the only way they knew one could be wet is if the one who eats you spits you out. And if you're not good for the one who eats you, you're certainly not good for your relatives. So they turned away and walked away from him and would not talk to Jumping Mouse. Jumping Mouse couldn't get the picture of those sacred mountains out of his head, and he became very lonely and he wanted to find those mountains. So he left. He went back down through the trail and up over the knoll and down to the river. And he asked Brother Frog, Brother Frog, how do I find those sacred mountains?
Jumping Mouse, just go in the direction you saw them.
Jumping Mouse thanked Brother Frog, and he started walking in the direction. As he walked along, he continued to see things and feel dirt under his feet that was new and different to him. And finally he came to the edge where the prairie meets the forest. He stood there and he looked, and all he could see was empty plains. And as he looked up, he saw dots in the sky, and he knew they were eagles.
He became worried about how he would get across because he knew those dots in the sky, those eagles, would see him and come down and catch him. As he looked, he finally, way off in the distance, he saw some sage growing. So he gathered up his courage and he ran as fast as he could, knowing any minute those eagles would get him. But he made it safe.
"Hello, little mouse."
And he turned around and there was a kangaroo rat. They talked for a while. Finally, Jumping Mouse asked the kangaroo rat, "Do you know of the sacred river and the sacred mountains?"
"Yes and no. The sacred river exists, for I have seen it. But the sacred mountains, they don't exist. It's just a tale, a myth."
Jumping Mouse was startled, for he knew they did, for he had seen them with his own two eyes. As they talked some more, the kangaroo rat told him he could stay as long as he liked, for there was plenty of dew for water on the sage leaves and the birds dropped plenty of seeds. Jumping Mouse explained he was going to make it to those sacred mountains. He thanked the kangaroo rat as he stood at the edge of the sage and knew those dots were still overhead. But yet he was going to go on, so he looked for some place he could make it to. Finally, way off in the distance, he saw a chokecherry growing. Once again, he gathered up his courage, and he ran as hard and as fast as he could, knowing those eagles were going to get him. But he made it safe into the chokecherry. As he was catching his breath, he heard a noise unlike anything he had ever heard. Jumping Mouse moved to the edge to see where this noise was coming from. And there he saw the largest clump of hair he could imagine, and it moved up and down with the noise. Slowly, part of it started to move, and as it did, Jumping Mouse realized it was a buffalo. He wondered what was wrong with this great being, this giver to the people, and he asked, "What's wrong?"
"I am told by my medicine that I am going to die unless I find the eye of a mouse. So I must die, for there is no such thing as a mouse."
This startled Jumping Mouse, for he was a mouse. And if the eye of a mouse could make whole this being, this giver to the people, and before he finished his thought, his left eye left his head. The buffalo stood up and the ground shook and the dust flew, and Jumping Mouse was scared, for he had never felt the ground move quite like that or seen that much dust, and he was only looking with his one eye. The buffalo looked at Jumping Mouse and said,
"Jumping Mouse, I know of your quest for those sacred mountains, and I know of your fear of those eagles overhead. Come stand under me, and I'll take you across the prairie, and those eagles won't see you."
Jumping Mouse adjusted to only seeing with one eye, but he scurried under the buffalo. And as they walked, the ground shook with every step. As he looked up, Jumping Mouse saw this great big body and these little tiny skinny legs. And he wondered, can these legs hold his body up all the way across this prairie? Finally, they got to the other side of the prairie. And there Jumping Mouse scurried out into the grass. The buffalo and Jumping Mouse talked for a short period of time. The buffalo looked at Jumping Mouse.
Jumping Mouse, you did not have to be afraid, for I walk in a good way, and my feet are sure in the Sundance path, and I belong on that prairie. You did not have to fear those eagles overhead, either. I must go back out where I belong now. Jumping Mouse thanked the buffalo as the buffalo went back out to the prairie where he lived. Jumping Mouse proceeded on to walk in the direction of those sacred mountains. Finally, he got to the foothills, and as he's making his way up through the rocks, there in front of him, not too far, lying down, was a wolf.
Hello, Mr. Wolf.
Wolf, 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 wolf.
Oh, I am a wolf.
Jumping Mouse realized that this way-shower had lost his memory. If he lost his memory, how could he help somebody? How could he show somebody the way anywhere? And it occurred to Jumping Mouse, if the eye of a mouse can make whole a buffalo, then maybe, and before he finished his thought, his right eye left his head. The wolf stood up.
Jumping Mouse, I know of your quest for those sacred mountains, and I know of your fear of those eagles. The trees will keep you covered from the eagles, and I will take you to where the trees no longer grow. I will sit with you as long as you like, but you will have to go the rest of the way on your own.
Jumping Mouse, adjusting to no sight at all, agreed. So he grabbed the wolf's tail, and they started to go up and up. Jumping Mouse could smell things again he had not smelled before, and he could feel different dirt and rocks under his feet. Finally, they got to where the trees no longer grow. They sat and they talked. The wolf told Jumping Mouse that he would know he had made it to the top, for there was a healing lake there, and when he could feel that water, he would know he was on top and had made it to the sacred mountains. Jumping Mouse thanked the wolf, and the wolf went back down to show others the way. So Jumping Mouse started to feel his way out, and finally, waiting for those eagles, knowing they would find him and he couldn't even run, he felt the water. He stopped and he sat down, and he waited. He didn't have to wait very long, and he could feel the shadow of those eagles coming down, and he felt a sharp pain in his back. And he felt himself being lifted higher and higher and higher. After a while, he heard a voice.
Jumping Mouse, open your eyes.
Jumping Mouse opened his eyes, and he could see like he did not know was possible. He could see the grass place where he lived. He could see his sister, his other relatives, his mother. He could see the buffalo on the prairie. He could see Brother Raccoon making his way down the river. He could see things he didn't know existed. And then he realized that it was Brother Frog that had hollered up at him. He looked down at Brother Frog, and Brother Frog hollered up at him one more time.
Jumping Mouse, you have a new name. It is Eagle.
Oh,